Hi, everybody. So, let's get really close. Come on in. Come on in. Come on. Come on. Come on. Everybody in. Get close. Get close. Hi, Helen. Hi, Mark. Hi, Jennifer. So, hi, everybody. I think I tried really hard to say hello to almost everybody when they came in, and I'm looking at the faces, I didn't. I'm Rodney Desjardins, and I have the pleasure of serving as the head of school, which has been a real pleasure. Annette and I and our family, we've been here for 12 years. And I have to tell you, it's interesting. This evening's kind of interesting for me because in our 12-year tenure, I can't tell you how many times I've heard about this generation of students, these families at the school, and how many times I've actually heard of Myrna. I really have. Myrna and Joel, I've heard a lot about them. And of course, the story that I was told, I think probably really early in my career here, was that they are, and as far as I know, they still are, the only parents in our Athletic Hall of Fame, which is really, really kind of great. For someone who's obviously is a parent and somebody who coached for 36 years and been in school my whole career, it's pretty special when you have parents that have the effect on generations of children as Myrna has and as Joel has. And I think that's pretty remarkable. And before I start, that brings me to the one thing I really wanted to say. You know, I have the pleasure of trying to help working with other people to help support schools like this and ask people for the funds so that we can build buildings and run our programs, and you know, that's part of the work that I do. And when you walk onto a campus like this, you see the names, you see the fact that people who came before us actually were willing to give something to the school so that people who followed could actually have great schools and great programs. So I've done my number of dedications, and I've talked to many people about supporting schools. This is the first time in my career, any time I've ever seen a facility named after a woman, a parent, a mother, who's had so much of an impact on a generation of children and other families that they were willing to name something after her. And I think that's absolutely amazing, and it's just such a great reason. So, Myrna's left you with memories, and of course those are the treasures somebody like Myrna leaves behind, and those are treasures that I know you'll always hold on to. There's stories, by the way, that lay under the foundation of what the school is, and to see her name now in several locations around that gym. Obviously, when you go in, you'll see her name on the wall. You'll see her name at both entrances, one outdoors and one indoors, and it's actually really special for us to do that. So I just think this is a pretty special night. I welcome you all here. I would like to very briefly just kind of explain to you what we're going to do so that we don't lose track. In here, we're just going to have a few really short words, and then what I'm going to do, and I would appreciate it, I'd like to get the Sherman family, the Klein family first to follow me through the door back there. People can follow through. I'm going to walk you through the back of the library, take a really short step into the Silverfine gym so that we don't really have to walk out. We're going to walk over to the gym, and outside the gym, once we get enough people gathered, we will unveil the plaque, the official plaque for the gym, for the Myrna B. Sherman Gymnasium, which is really, really kind of exciting. And then, you ready for this? This is the daring part for all of you. You hang on to this. We're going to walk into a gym, and we're going to line up all of us along this ribbon that will be stripped across the middle gym. Everybody has to do this. You cannot chicken out. Okay? And we're going to have the Shermans and the Klein family in the middle. We're going to give Joel the biggest pair of scissors he's ever seen in his life. And by the way, what's really fascinating, and it's kind of a neat metaphor for athletics, is we're going to get out there, and before we cut the ribbon, they're going to announce the two teams that are playing, and the players for the team will actually hold the ribbon on both ends, which I think is a really sweet metaphor for, I think, the best of everything that we want out of athletics. We'll ask Joel to cut the ribbon, and then we're all going to stand still on the court, and our jazz band is going to play the Star Spangled Banner. We have saved a whole bunch of seats for you in the middle of the gym for you to sit and enjoy the game. We're going to talk about that in a second. Mm-hmm. And we really do hope you enjoy at least the first half, because the boys basketball team is just a pleasure to watch play. And it would be really great if you stayed for at least the first half. I know many of you have other things to go to afterwards, which is kind of exciting. A little bit about the gym, particularly for those, there's so many alumni in here. We have put a new roof on the outside of the gym. We've taken care of some underground water problems. We, believe it or not, for the alumni, you'll love this, we've now had the air, it's a full HVAC package on the gym. You won't feel it tonight, but it's air conditioned, it's humidity controlled, and it's heated. So the players that go in there in the summer, the spring, and the fall are just mesmerized that it's now an air-conditioned gym. One of the most exciting things about it is there is now a wooden floor in the gym, and it's actually stunning. The paint has been redone, the hoops are all brand new, the scoreboards are new. Outside in the lobby of the gym are all brand new display cases that are so new, we have yet to now move all the trophies back into it. That's gonna be our work. And the most exciting thing about the gym and working with contractors is the bleachers are not there yet. We've had this beautiful set of bleachers. We've had some issues with contractors. My team has worked really well on it. So this may be the only time, and the other school's gonna be like, is this what independent schools are like? We're gonna go in there and there's a whole bunch of white chairs in the basketball game. It's actually quite stunning, and I'm sure the other team's gonna leave going, that was really strange. So that's kind of what we're in for, and I think about the middle of January with bleachers, I hope some of you come back and see the boys and or the girls play in the winter. It's really great. And again, I thank you all for being here. It's great to see you. And what's really important is the fact that we have such great stories of these families, of this whole generation of people at the school, and of what Myrna and Joel did together, and tonight in particular, Myrna. So with that said, I would like to introduce Michael Klein, the class of 81, who's very responsible for the work that's being done tonight. And Michael has done tremendous work for the school. He's been a great supporter. He was probably one of our best graduation speakers of all time. And Michael, would love to hear from you a little bit.
Show up,
so. Hey Joel, do you want to come up here and sit down? We're going to give you a special seat. Yeah. Come on up, Joel. Come on.
Yeah. Well, thank you for that. That was very generous. And thank you, everybody, for braving this snowy evening to come out. It's a great event and it's an exciting event, and we're all thrilled to be here. I want to also, in particular, note the class of 1981 and those that are sort of surrounded by it, who we timed this event to be timed on the same day as the very famous John Vogue Custom Liners Christmas lunch. This is, I think, the 27th year of that. Now, John was the first of our whole generation to have an expense account, so he decided that he was gonna throw a Christmas lunch for anyone who could come. And we're such good friends that it took 24 years before any of us went in our pocket to share. So it's about year 25 it became more of a group Christmas lunch, but it's great to have you here.
We missed you.
I didn't make it. But we're here actually, and I get the honor to read the plaque, the actual decoration, which I will in a moment, but we're actually here tonight to celebrate one great Dwight Angwood family, the Shermans. We're here to celebrate one fantastic partnership and 54-year love affair, Joel and Myrna. And we're here to celebrate one fantastic woman, Myrna Sherman. And that's why we're here. And a lot of you have relationships, and a lot of you have points of view, and I had the honor and privilege of growing up with the Shermans. In fact, I knew Billy, I knew Missy or Michelle. I tried to date many of her friends. my sister went to the prom with Larry, so there's a lot of history. But really, what makes this more special is about 2 years ago, I got a call from Billy, and it was one of these calls that it's really flattering when you get from a friend who says, look, I have a question for you. Given what you do in life, can you give me just a little bit of counsel? And I won't belabor what it was all about, but we ended up spending a year and a half together, myself with the Sherman family. And it was really a great, great, great privilege for me. It was an honor for me. And I learned a handful of things about the family that made me feel particularly exciting and warm and honored to be a part of them during a critical time in their life. The first is, it really is a unique thing to have three individuals in a generation who share equally in a business that they've taken on from their parents and that they work as such unbelievable partners. The partnership experience in the Sherman family is extraordinary. And I got to witness that. And I got to witness not just three people who cared about each other so much, but they cared about their employees and they cared about their ancestors in all aspects of what was a 7, 8, 9 decade business. The second thing I learned, which probably was the most moving every single day, was how much the children cared about Joel. And when I say that I've never lived in a situation where a business owners were considering something about their business, where their principal focus was, I just need to know where I can take my dad to lunch every day, because he comes into the office every day, and if I don't have the office, where am I going to take him every day? That subject came up almost every week. But the thing that really moved me most was I got a text at one point from Billy. And I think it was a late summer, and he texted me and he said, I'm walking underneath a moon, and I can't help but to think, holy shit. Now that's a technical term, it just meant exciting. But he then went on to say that I think as I'm walking under this moon, that it's my mom who's shining down proud of all of us. And I have to say, you don't get a lot of texts like that. You don't get a lot of moving moments like that. And it really does make you think what Ralph Waldo Emerson said, which is men really are who their mothers make them. And I think that's absolutely the case in the Sherman boys and, of course, the Sherman daughters and the 8 great-grandchildren. I think it's unique. So we're here to celebrate for, I guess, the second time, because the Shermans are in the Athletic Hall of Fame here. So this is now the second time we get something. But this is a big celebration for Myrna Sherman, an extraordinary woman. And I'm going to read this now. And it says, the restoration of this gymnasium, which has occurred, will hereinafter be named the Myrna B. Sherman Gymnasium. The Myrna B. Sherman Gymnasium will endure as a significant and critical facility, serving as the primary location on campus for practices, competitive athletics, and community building events. The Myrna B. Sherman Gymnasium, located adjacent to the Silver Fine Gymnasium, serves as a testimony to the closeness of the relationships within the Dwight Engler class of 1981 and its families. Finally, the Myrna B. Sherman Gymnasium reflects the best of our Dwight Englewood school community as we honor an exceptional woman, a mother of 3 talented student athletes who literally never missed a game. And I think when you walk in today and you see the signage, you'll be pleased, as I am, that Myrna Sherman, who tragically is not with us tonight, she never missed a game, and now from this night onward, she will never miss a game again. So with that, I hand it over to Billy. Thank you.
We're going to do this as a tag team, so first of all, Smitty planned this day, so if anyone had a problem with the weather, it's all his fault. Where is he even? He's probably out there somewhere. You know, I can't start this by not recognizing Michael. I know Bill's going to kind of chime in there, but what Michael has done for our family is something truly special, and I can't think of anyone, really, or very few people in my life that have had the impact that he has, and he spoke so beautifully, and so it's a little always difficult to follow someone like that. But I did, on the back of an envelope, literally, write down a couple of comments so I didn't forget. You know, it wasn't necessarily always easy for my family, actually. I remember living on Lantana Avenue in Englewood, and the decision my parents made to sacrifice to send us to Dwight Englewood was an economic decision. And one that they willingly did for us, which was an unbelievable thing, and I think we are all very fortunate and prosperous because of it. And speaks a lot to this school and about the opportunities that were available in this school. And I think it's something truly special. You know, obviously Michael mentioned the Hall of Fame, and Dad used to always tell a joke, I actually used it last night, about youth, middle age, and you guys all look like you haven't changed. I adapted that for tonight, but my mom was tireless, and that included hosting jazz rock in her living room, bake ziti for the football games on Friday, the team, cheerleaders, and clearly never missing a game. It was something both my parents took great pride in, and I've struggled to, in this day and age, to try to accomplish that same thing. But one of the things that she always really did was make this school and our house a place that everyone felt welcome. And so I really just want to just quickly comment that we hope that this gym can be a place and a room where this school and the future students within this school can flourish and become really a united community. And that was truly something that I think she struggled to accomplish. So I'm going to give it off to Bill or Michelle. We won't take two.
You know, this night has such mixed emotions of joy and my mom's energy. You feel exuberance. It had to snow tonight because she loves snow. So sorry it took so long for people to get here, but she really was all about the snow and about people and her love for the students in the school or our friends, everybody was welcomed with open arms. Each one of us has a story in this room about my mom. And to Michael and his family for being so there for us, genuinely and with such gratitude. Thank you so much, Michael.
Thanks. And I think by after you go third year, it's getting a little more. So I really think what everyone was explaining, Michael and Larry and Michelle certainly, was mom's spirit of inclusion and mom's spirit of, you know, making a home for everyone and for everyone to be included. And I really can't think of a better place here on campus, which has been such a big part of all of our lives here, a gym where everyone can be included and be together. And I think it's just a wonderful fitting place for having mom to watch over. It is about community, it is about friendship, and it's just overwhelming what all this is here, and all the friends from both, all of the different grades that we've been in, Larry, Michelle, and I. It is that sense of community, and it is that, it's more than that, it is family. I think everyone expressed how deeply grateful we are to Michael and his family for what they did, and you know, I think that kind of bond has worked for all of us as we've been together. Although it's going to be called the Myrna B. Sherman Gym, there is going to be, we're very excited to have a small plaque within there to remind all the students and future students of what that means to be part of a community and the friendships, and hopefully they can learn from all the friendships that we've created here. So I'm very proud to be able to have this plaque that's going to read, "Thank you. Friendships formed here embrace the spirit of the Dwight Engwood School. Cherish your friendships, for they will help define you and last a lifetime. The Sherman family is grateful for a lifetime of friendships with the Klein family, and thanks Michael Klein, Class 81, particularly for his overwhelming generosity, guidance, and thoughtfulness."
Here, here.
That spirit, and that's why this is so beautiful. And so, thank you for all of you guys being here tonight. So, thanks to share.
You hardly left me anything to say. It is still looking at all of the people who look like it, just like they did in 81. I recognize you all. And it's been a wonderful thing working with Michael and working with school. And we never feel far away from Dwight. It has a tentacles that reach out and touch you in all sorts of things that you try and do or think about or do. It creates a style of life, a way of being for a large family. And I am very proud the Mariner has gotten her name put there and been recognized, because that's something that really transcends anything I could have done or thought about. So that's something I have to be very thankful to all of you for. And certainly, Mariner would have loved to have been here.
Thank you for all coming. You feel the same moment we're all feeling. These are the moments that make community, and I hope that everyone here, you're proud of the school, you're still proud of the school, you're proud of what we're doing, but please know that what we do today wouldn't be possible if it wasn't the moments like these that you created. So thank you very much. We're going to try to walk the Shermans and the Kleins. Please follow us. We'll get them up to the plaque, and then be brave. Go on this path. First of all, welcome to tonight's dedication to the parents from Richfield Memorial. Thank you for joining us this night. Tonight we have the pleasure of dedicating a renovation of what we used to call Big Gym, and now we will give it a name. And for the fans, as you can tell, this is a renovation project that every single aspect of this building, hoops, floors, rooftop, HVAC, paint, everything is new. And yes, you guessed it. We didn't get the bleachers yet. So I just don't want you to get the wrong impression that in my neighborhood school, we sit in chairs and watch basketball games. But maybe we'll put it up in our chairs and hopefully the next time we have the digital game. Just a little bit to everybody here so you understand that this is one of those rare opportunities that we have to dedicate a gym to a parent. A family, Myrna and Joel Sherman, who were parents of many children, three children at the school, and a generation of children that went through the school who were their very best friends. Myrna and Joel are the only parents in our school Hall of Fame. The Athletic Hall of Fame includes two parents, and that's Myrna and Joel. And unfortunately, Myrna passed away a few years ago. And the families that are involved and friends of the family decided that they would like to dedicate this gym to a mother who had such an effect on the athletes over many generations, and somebody who never missed a game, had a tremendous impact on the athletes who played and the people who went to this school for a very long period of time. And it was my honor to give the scissors to her husband, Joel Sherman, and the Sherman family and the Klein family who are in the middle, two families that have been very important to the history of the school, to cut the ribbon. And just so we know what's going to happen after we cut the ribbon, we are going to introduce the starting lineup, and everybody's still going to stay here, and then we're going to do our national anthem, and then we'll give you the seats in the middle. It's been a pleasure to have you all back at school. It's truly an honor. Richfield Memorial, thank you very much for being part of this program. Here we go. Ready?
Michael.
And here we go. The official ribbon cutting for the Myrna P. Sherman.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts Word so God.